You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we tell you all about how to get free data into your own machine learning workflow. Make sure you check it out. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about data, but data that you can get for free, I think. Manoj, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, Seth. This is Manoj. I work with the AI platform team, and I'm the PM driving Azure Open Datasets that we'll be talking about today.
So let's talk about Azure Open Datasets. What is it?
Open Datasets, like, it's a platform to share and collaborate with open data on Azure. We have a bunch of datasets onboarded, and we're looking forward to the community to get more. So that's
amazing. So it's basically a place where people can put data.
Yep. Data now, from the open domain.
Okay, from the open domain, so not just any data.
Not just any data.
So let's dive in, because I feel like this is kind of squishy for me. Mm-hmm. So let's dive in into one of the data sets maybe, and let's talk about, like, where do you get the data and why it might be useful. Mm-hmm. Because if it's an open data set, my sense is that it will be about general data, right?
Yeah.
So let's find a data set and let's see what's in there.
Great. First of all, like, this is where you kind of start exploring these data sets. Like, this is the open data sets page. We talk about what this stuff is, and I think let's dive into the dataset catalog.
Let's do it.
So, bunch of datasets listed here. You could go ahead and search some, but the favorite one of mine that I like to show is, like, the weather dataset.
Okay.
So, this is a dataset from NOAA, which has, like, a lot of cool datasets related to weather from weather stations across the world, radar data, and all of that. So this is the dataset overview page, and here is a very quick preview. Like, now remember, if you directly go to the NOAA site, it would be, like, hard for you to look at this data. But here you are able to, like, get a quick preview. And then if you want, you could understand what the schema looks like, what are some of the sample values, and all of that stuff.
So this is pretty amazing. Where does this data come from? Because generally, like, nowadays, when we're talking about AI, machine learning, and deep learning specifically, there's concern about where data comes from. Where does this data come from, number one? And number two, how could it be useful? Because I'm having trouble understanding how maybe weather data would help me in my own machine learning stuff.
Great, great. So your first question, where does this data come from? So because this is open data, it's all from the open domain from various sources, like government institutions like NOAA, the U.S., Bureau of Labor Statistics for socioeconomic data.
Got it.
And all of that stuff. How does this data come in? Like, I think we are putting together a framework building on top of all of the existing Azure infrastructure and services. Like, as you can see in the diagram here, most of these open data endpoints are exposed as FTP endpoints or some other stuff like that. So we use scripts using the Azure Data Factory to, like, script that data and get it onboarded to Azure. And then, like, we have a thin layer of SDK that sits on top of it and makes the data easily accessible.
So if I'm understanding this right, basically you're making it a lot easier, because generally I would have to download this data that you're seeing, like this, and then I would have to shape it and do the things and put it maybe into a data frame.
Exactly.
But you're basically already doing that.
Which could be like weeks worth of work
right,
to just get our data and, like, clean it up and make it transportable into a data frame, right?
So the second question was, where are we getting this data? Is it just basically any public data that's available? Is there a way for me to submit myself?
Oh, that's a good question. So we do accept contributions. Basically, if you're looking to onboard data to the Open Datasets platform, we have an email ID on the page here that you can, like, just mail us at, and then we can get in touch with you. So the other important thing that I kind of wanted to call out is, like, why are we hosting these data sets?
Yeah. Right?
Like, that was probably the second question.
Yeah, like, the second question was, I forgot, how is this useful?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So remember, like, if you are working with, like, let's say you are working on a machine learning problem, either be it something like predictive maintenance or sales forecasting or anything like that, right? All these problems are impacted by outcomes in the real world or factors in the real world. So if you kind of enrich your data with these factors that impact your business outcomes or real world outcomes, you can get, like, better model accuracy and stuff like that. So that's the motivation on why we are, like, doing this. So that's what we call out here, right? And then, like, you know, okay, like, that makes sense. You could go to any of these sites and get the data yourself and, like, do the stuff. So why is it, like, important to have this platform, right?
Right.
Many of these data sets are, like, really large, terabytes. And, you know, if you talk about satellite imagery and stuff like that, that could be, like, petabytes as well, right? So it would be a lot of effort for you to get this data from place X to place Y, mm-hmm. right? So, and if you are running your compute on Azure, co-locating the data on the platform where your compute is running is super valuable.
Of course.
Right.
So then I think the answer is twofold. Number mm-hmm. one, using this data to augment your data. Like exactly. for example, there's probably, and I've seen this all the time, like in time series forecasting, mm-hmm. if there is a holiday,
exactly.
and you don't know it's a holiday, exactly. right? That data is so important to be able to predict how much it's gonna cost, right? And if you don't have that in your initial sales data, which you don't, you just have the date, augmenting data to do prediction is even more important.
Absolutely. So, and you guessed it right. Like, for example, we have the public holidays data set here, right?
See, there you go. I knew it.
Yep.
I knew it. And so, and the second thing is that you can totally get this data, but if it's terabytes of data, you're going to have to pull it somewhere, pay for that storage, yep. pay for the data transfer. But if you're using it on Azure, you basically get that already there.
Yes, and we are footing the bill for the storage. So all these data sets are on there and on Azure, and you just take a part of it, whatever is relevant to you, copy it over or read it directly from a data frame or anything like that.
Well, this is awesome.
Let's look
into that. I feel like we need to see it, right? We've talked yeah. about it. Let's take a look.
Yep. So let's look at this weather data, and we have a tab here called Data Access.
Okay.
It kind of easily shows you a sample snippet that lets you copy this data and get going. So I can just copy it and for the sake of doing this quickly, I've pasted it here and run it just a minute ago. And you can see that I'm specifying a start date and end date, and I'm saying that, get me this data and then convert this object into a data, pandas data frame. And that's all I do. And then it kind of downloads some files from Azure Storage and does some processing, and then here you go.
All right, let's scroll up. I want to see this because I think you went super fast. So you have something that says from AzureML.OpenDatasets import NOAA
ISD weather.
That's cool. So it's basically like a Python package.
Yes.
And you just pull stuff down.
Exactly.
That's
exactly.
awesome. Yep. I mean, it's pretty easy to do that, which yep. it looks pretty
exactly.
cool.
Exactly. And now I think there might be some folks out there who might say, oops, I'm not using Python, so how do I get this, right? Mm-hmm. So the fallback is that, you could always use the Azure Storage SDK, which is available in multiple languages.
Okay.
We publish what is the Azure Storage account and what's the container name, which folder you have to look into. And then you could use something like an Azure Storage Explorer, which is a GUI to go browse this data, or use the multiple languages in which the Azure Storage SDK is supported to get this data, like you're doing C# kind of stuff.
This is pretty cool. I mean, yep. I really like the fact that we have picked a set of data sets that may or may not be helpful, but
yeah.
pick them.
Yeah.
But you can also find a way to submit your own if you think they're important.
Yep.
And then the value that I'm seeing is to augment your data sets, to save on storage, and yep. to number three, we've seen now, be able to use an SDK
yep.
to make it pretty easy.
Exactly.
Well, this is so cool, man. Anything you want to add?
Yep. I think most of our users are using stuff with Azure Machine Learning Service, mm-hmm. so I'd like to show how can you get this data very easily.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah,
AML.
I want to see that too. Yeah.
Yep. So here I'm logged into my Azure Machine Learning workspace, and then we have this datasets hub here. You can come over and then you could choose to create a new data set.
Uh-huh.
And there you go. We just have integration to get you open data sets right
Holy
in
cow.
My machine learning workspace.
So I thought it couldn't get any better, but then you do something like this.
Yep.
This is awesome.
So you pull up, and then we have listed all the data sets here. If you want, you could go click on some of these links and get a description. I'm interested in public holidays, so I can go here and look at what that is. We saw this just mm-hmm. a while ago. Coming back, and let me take this, and then go next. I can give it a name, my public holidays, and then I could choose a time range for which I want this data.
Oh, that's cool.
And maybe if you want to filter by a country code, you can do that, but let me just go ahead and create this.
And then basically what it's doing is it's creating a reference to that data set.
Exactly. The data is not being copied over, right? So you can see here, this is now registered here. And you must have heard about Azure Machine Learning datasets. Mm-hmm. If not, there's a video for that one. We can go take a look. But then we give you this code snippet that lets you access this data in any of your Azure machine learning pipelines and all of that stuff. It's like registered now and for that particular date range, right? So data scientists can like create some filters, they can process all of this and then like register it as a data set and make it easily accessible for all your people or your teammates using the workspace.
This is amazing. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Anything Great. Else to finally want to add?
Oh, this is excited about this and looking forward to contributions and all of that stuff to grow the platform.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you so much for watching. We were learning all about open data sets. If you want to learn more, go to aka.ms/AZ Open Datasets. We'll see you there. Take care.